This lecture is about Baroque architecture style, covering the syllabus of history of architecture. Baroque architecture style is a style that emerged in Italy in the late 16th century in the continuation of Renaissance architecture style. It was a more theatrical version of Renaissance architecture with dramatic lighting and color, illusionary effects such as trompanile, and designs that played games with architecture features, sometimes leaving them incomplete. In this type of architecture style, churches, the facade of churches were made like a stage of a theater with dramatic lighting and the use of colors. Baroque literally means irregular, or it is sometimes deciphered as misshapen pearl. It was evolved in Italy in 1620 AD, and it is characterized by new exploration of form, light, shadow, and its dramatic intensity on the facades of the churches. Initially, at least, it was directly linked to the Counter-Reformation and then to a visible statement of the wealth and power of the In the previous lectures, we have studied that how Renaissance architecture style has been evolved. It has been evolved to give the importance to humanity that was not there in the previous architecture style, that was the Gothic architecture style. The importance were given to the churches, to the religious building rather than the civic buildings. But now when we move from early, high and late Renaissance coming to Baroque, again the importance and the wealth that has to be spent was there for the church buildings. And this new style was particularly for the churches or religious buildings made for the new cult or new sect that has been involved of the Christianity, that was Thetans and the Jesuits. And the peoples who propagate this style was Urban VIII, Innocent X and Alexander VII. The main architects of this style were Bernini, Bromini and Cortana. These architects were basically the sculptors. There was regional variation in the south of Italy, such as Sicily Baroque architecture style or that of Naples and Lecce. To the north, the Thetan architect Camillo Gorini, Gorono Gorini, the Vitone, and Filippo Guava contribute Baroque buildings to the city of Turin and the Piedmont region. Bernini, Bromini, and Cortana were responsible for creating building for the late Baroque architecture style, and that paved a path or led to the invention of more decorative style, that was Rococo architecture style. Characteristics of Baroque architecture: vast scale, curved form which produce an effect of movement in churches, broad naves and sometimes given oval forms. So basically the use of oval forms, complex geometry was the characteristics of Baroque architecture. New types of plan and experiment with new spatial inventions. Simple geometries was used to invent new forms and complex geometries. Fragmentary or deliberately incomplete architectural elements, and that has come from the Mannerist style. Dramatic use of light, either strong light and shade contrast, and that effect is called chiaroscuro effect in the building. Complexity and richness of materials that has been seen in the buildings. They are human scale buildings, but the decoration is very minutely done and very beautifully done. Opulent use of colors and ornaments. Putti or figures made of wood were used, wood often gilded. Plasters or stucco, marble or flox finish were used. Large-scale ceiling frescoes were made. Effect of illusionism was there in the Baroque architecture style, and that is done by imitating one form of the art into the another. Effect like trompanile, that is an art technique involving extreme realistic imagery in order to create the optical illusion that the depicted objects appear in three dimensions, and the bleeding of painting and architecture. Sculptor introduced color in their works. Architects used sculpture to support the members of the building, and decorating walls and vaults of the church with false architecture perspectives. Pear-shaped domes were used. So by introducing or imitating one form of art into the another, the effect of illusions has been created in the building. That is the main characteristics of Baroque architecture. Michelangelo's St. Peter Basilica may be considered as a precursor to Baroque architecture style, as it has used the form that is having a curved shape, and cornice is used to encircle the building in the form of ribbon. And his pupil Porta continued his work in Rome, particularly in the facade of Jesuit church, that is Gesù. And this church was inspired by the Alberti Sad Andrea in Mantua. In Alberti, Alberti has used triumphal arch facade in St. Andrea. And this was the inspiration for Porta that has been used in this church. It leads directly to the most important church for facade of early Baroque, that is Santa Susanna by Carlo Maderno. So Carlo Maderno also adopted the same features in his buildings while designing this church. This is the plan of Church Second by Gesù, in which you can see the columns, the pyres that has been used. It represent the pyres or columns of St. Peter Basilica. This is the facade of Santa Susanna in Gesù. It resembles the facade of this Jesuit church in Gesù. So it has a scroll that has been invented in High Renaissance period. So this Baroque architecture style is generally a conversion of early Renaissance, from early Renaissance to high late, and then Baroque architecture style, in which the decoration, the use of curvilinear form, the use of complex geometries has been added. The dramatic rhythm of columns, pilasters, central massing, and the protrusion and condensed central decoration add complexity to the structure. There is an incipient playful with the rules of classic design, but it is still maintained rigor. You can see there is a playfulness in the design, the use of classical geometry is there. Is still there in the early Baroque architecture style. This is the facade in which the curvilinear forms are used in the facade. The decoration has been added in a more elaborate way, which was not there in early and high Renaissance. The use of sculpture has been added, and it has been set into the niches that is. The main feature of Baroque architecture style. Baroque architecture style in South Italy, it's Cortona who had designed Santi Lucia e Martina, this church. So you can see this facade has a curved shape. This has a curved shape and probably the first curved Baroque church in the room. It has plasticity, massing, dramatic effects, shadow and light the use of shadow and light in the facade of the church. This is the facade of this church in this you can see it has a curvilinear features in his apse, the four apes. It has all the four apes has been curved. This church is called Santa Maria della Pace. The more use of curvilinear geometry, chiaroscuro effect has been added in this church. This is a church built later. So this porch that has been extended beyond the church facade, that is the curvilinear porch, it has columns in the peristyle form. This has added the effect of light and shadow on the facade of the church. The facade with this chiaroscuro half-dome portico and curved side wings, this is the curved side wings, closely resembles a theatrical stage set. So what we have discussed in the first slide, that this architecture style is famous for its setting of stage. The facade has been set like a theater stage with the use of light and shadow. The church facade projects forward so that it substantially fills the tiny trapezoidal piazza. You can see this is a piazza in which this semicircular porch has been extended out. This is a sketch of this church in which you can see this is the semicircular porch that has been extended out, and this is a trapezoidal piazza, and this piazza is basically left for the chariots of the emperors or the patronages to be turned around. And it has been, the church facade has been extended by these convex extended walls. We can see it has two effects. It is concave porch and a convex wall behind it, and looks like a stage. In front of that stage, there's a trapezoidal piazza. Very famous architect of this architecture style is Bernini. Bernini is known as a painter, sculptor, and architect. This is his most famous, you can see this picture, this is his most famous fountain, that is Fountain of the Four Rivers, and it is located in Rome, Italy. Bernini was favorite of Urban VIII and Alexander VII. He was settled in Rome by his sculptor before he was 20. He was a skillful painter. His art was splendid in conception and lavish in execution. He thought in terms of marble, gilding, and dramatic lighting, and he loved grand scale. So he made his building in grand scale. He painted, wrote, plays, and designed metalwork and stage set. Bernini's own favorite design was San Andrea al Coronale. This church has been decorated with polychrome marble and a very ornate gold dome. And his secular buildings include Palazzo Bernini and Palazzo Chigi Odeschi. And both these buildings are there in Rome. San Andrea al Coronale has an oval plan, which has, you can see in this, it has oval plan. This church was built for Jesuits, and it is similar to the Maderno's plan that is called Santa Susanna. It has a painting of Saint Andrew in his apse. Facade projecting out, you can see this facade is projecting out to welcome the peoples or the person that are coming in. Sculpture of the chancel, you can see there's a sculpture of the chancel rise as to meet his rewards in the heaven. It has been placed such that it looks like it has been rising his hands to meet his rewards in the heaven. So this again has a curvilinear porch and a semicircular steps in the entry point. So this circular element has been added, and the church has been designed in a oval format. It has apse. You can see this is an apse. First is this is the entry, and another all the parts are there. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the apse of the church, and the front one has the painting of the Saint Andrew. This is the interior of this church. This church has been richly coffered dome, golden color dome, extremely decorated by heavy scrolls. You can see these are the scrolls that has been used. So these scrolls have been invented in Renaissance, but used in very different ways in the Baroque architecture style. These was heavily decorated scrolls. Column with delicate pinkish red marble. This is the interior of the building, which has the it has these pinkish marble decoration over the column with delicate pinkish red marble, dramatic space and imagery. So how the plan has been evolved of Saint Courtyard? It has the two circles has been used to derive this ellipse form of this church. Saint Peter's Square is the most famous architectural design in the Baroque architecture style, and it has been designed by Bernini. It is formed principally by the two colonnades of freestanding columns. You can see these are the two colonnades of freestanding columns centered by this Egyptian obelisk. Carlo Maderno added the base of nave in 1605 and finished the broad facade in 1612. You can see these are the stages in which the St. Peter Basilica Church was designed. This is the old St. Peter Basilica that was in 4th century. This is Bramante's plan that has been selected for new St. Peter Basilica in 1506. Then when Michelangelo was appointed as an architect for St. Peter Basilica, then he redesigned, considering the plan of this Bramante's plan, and redesigned the plan. So he has removed all the columns in between and used only four columns, making the space of aisles and the nave clear. On these four columns, doubly shelled dome has been placed with an oculus above it. So in later ages, Maderno has designed this extended nave with a narthex, with a narthex in front of that nave. It has broad facade. You can see in this picture, it has broad facade in front of the in front of the Saint Peter Basilica. So now still the building does not look complete. So there's a need of a piazza. There's a need of a piazza in to gather people. So this is a plan, existing plan of Saint Peter Basilica. This was a plan designed by Michelangelo and Maderno. So it has, but there was a restriction of the space. So there was a space that was in the form of trapezoid and in the form in oval shape form. So the piazza has been divided into two parts. First part is the trapezoidal part and another part is the ellipse part. This ellipse part has a colonnade on the side of the piazza with a Egyptian obelisk in the center. Again, at the two ends of the oval piazza, there is a fountain. So you can see in this how a simple geometry has been used to design this piazza, the trapezoidal part and this the oval shape of this piazza. So at the center of the oval shape there is a obelisk, and then there are two circles creating the ellipse. The center of the ellipse has been used to place this fountain. So this plan shows the Saint Peter Basilica, Saint Peter's Square and the Vatican Palace. So this is a plan showing the Obelix fountain, the piazza in front of the trapezoidal piazza in front of the church, and the oval piazza in front of the trapezoidal piazza. It's the view of this piazza. It has a circular colonnade, obelisk, fountain, the raised trapezoidal platform to address the gathering. So these sculptures are like giving blessings to the crowd that has been collect in this piazza. Another very famous architect of Baroque architecture style was Bromini. He was an Italian architect and trained sculptor born in today's Ticino, who with his contemporaries Bernini and Cortano was a leading figure in the emergence of Roman Baroque architecture. So he was very important architect that led to the development of Baroque architecture style. Bromini is one of my favorite architect. He was Bernini's rival, but opposite to him. He produced designs deviated dramatically from the regular composition of the ancient world and Renaissance. So he designed very complex geometries and very unusual and inventives. He was keen student of Michelangelo. His plans were based on complex geometric figures. His architecture forms were unusual and inventive, and he employed multi-layer symbolism in his architecture design. So he, you can see in his design, he has used many complex geometries but derived from very simple forms. Bronini has a sound knowledge of sculpture, which Bernini and Cortana do not have. So he was a self-taught scholar. He has a very massive library at the end of his life. But his career was not very famous and constrained by his personality, because as Bernini was famous among his patronage, he has charming and very good personality, but Bromini was very melancholy, and he got to have very quick temper, which deserted him in drawing from certain jobs. So he do not he had made very less buildings in his lifestyle, and his death was by suicide, because he was very melancholy and a quick-tempered person, and he got very little success in his lifetime. For more than two centuries after his death, he was regarded as a madman. It was said that he has broken and destroyed all the architectural rules. Antiquity and rigorous geometrical system was his characteristics, and he has made small scale buildings and usually used materials like brick and stucco. You can see he was very opposite to Bernini. In this the Bernini has designed and executed huge number of buildings, large number of buildings, because he was liked by the patronage and scholars. But Bromini has designed less number of buildings. He was short-tempered, quick-tempered. Bernini also designed. He was fond of designing large-scale buildings, while Bromini has designed small-scale buildings. So his famous project was San Carlo el Quattro Fontana. It is a church situated at the site of two new street, at the corner of which four new public fountains were built. The plan combines oval shapes and the equilateral triangle. Four pendentives that rise to form the oval base ring by a deep coffered oval dome. Dome opened at the top by a lantern. You can see this, it has a coffered dome and that opens in a lantern. And lantern shows there is a equilateral triangle showing a figure of dove, which is considered as a Holy Spirit. And it says that that there is a Holy Spirit above it, and this is a key to the entire composition of its design. You can see this how it has been evolved. It has a equilateral triangle and a two circles to form an ellipse. These triangles, the point, the one is the entry point and other is the apse. Partly oval and partly a cross, and so has complex convex geometry wall rhythm. This facade has convex concave wall rhythm in its design, which is added, which has been designed to add a mystery, to add a effect of light and shadow, which is called chiaroscuro effect in the building. This is the interior. Interior is white because he usually used brick and stucco work in his buildings. Another building designed by him is Sant Leo della Spensa. A later work, the Church of Sant Leo della Spensa, added to the University of Rome, displayed the same playful inventiveness and antipathy to the flat surfaces, epitomized by an unusual corkscrew lantern above the dome. You can see this is a corkscrew lantern that has been added above the dome of the church. This was placed at the end of the long courtyard. This is a plan of this this church, and this has been added to the in the university courtyard of a university, and has placed at the end of this courtyard. Plan based on the system of equilateral triangle. These equilateral triangles placed on one another over another, one over another, forming a hexagonal star shape. Such a form was never being used. So the form that has been derived, that has been invented by the Bromini, was never been used before. Three of the lobes pointed by one triangle forming semicircular apes. See this, the center has been kept like this, and then this is how a semicircular ace has been created, and other has been designed like keeping the point of the triangle as a center. Another circle has been drawn, and a convex type of wall has been created. So three convex walls and three concave walls to form an apse. So this is how this, the form of this church has been created. And above that form, the same form of the dome has been created. The dome that has been created represents the same form of the plan. It has Corinthian columns, cornices, unique deep molding domes like other Renaissance architecture styles. This is the view of from the courtyard of this church, and these are the elements that was there in the interior of the building. The cornice has been moving from in the interior like the plan moves, as the plan moves. Cortana was born as Pietro Berrettini, but it was primarily known by the name of his native town of Cortana in Tuscany. He was a painter, but as a side work, he was an architect. His church facade are designed almost like stage sets, planned to catch the dramatic contrast of light and shade in the strong Roman sun. He also renovated the exterior renewal of the ancient Santa Maria della Pace and the facade of Santa Maria in Via Lata. This is the Santa Maria della Pace, in which he has redesigned the facade of the church, in which we have discussed earlier how the facade has been set like a theatrical stage. Facade was added by Cortana, contrived to give symmetry to an irregular group of buildings, providing enough room for aristocratic worshippers to turn their coaches. So this piazza has been left so that the chariots of the aristocratic worshippers can be rotated and turn around. So Baroque in Northern Italy has been followed by Guarini, Guava and Vittone. They had been used the style in very sophisticated and elaborated way. They illustrated the grandiose political ambitions, the new acquired royal status of their dynasty. Guarini was the follower of Bromini. He has also designed a complex geometry coming out from the simpler ones. And he was admirer of Gothic architecture style and the Muslim structures. So he have used ribs, multiple ribs to form the domes, which stands out against the light from the lantern which they support. You can see this is a church, dome of the church. Multiple ribs has been used to create the domes, and this lantern has been created by using these multiple ribs. The interior of cupola church of Saint Lorenzo, that is in Turin. Guarini is famous for its irregular structures using oval columns and unconventional facades. Building upon the findings of contemporary geometry and stereometry. Stereometry is a design of creating the figures from the biblical themes. Guarini elaborated the concept of architectura oblica, which approximated Bromini's style in both theoretical and structural audacity. Architectura oblica, making complex or the curvilinear geometries using a linear and formal geometries. Guarini's Palazzo Carignano may have been the most flamboyant application of Baroque architecture style to designed to offer private house in 17th century. This is a Palazzo Carignano. You can see this in the previous slides. You have seen the Baroque architecture style has been used in most of the churches, a small scale and the large scale churches. They have used the architecture style because this Baroque architecture style has been evolved for the churches only to show the might and the wealth that has been gained by any dynasty. So this is the first project in which the Baroque architecture has been, the style has been used in a palazzo in a very elaborate way. The curvilinear facade has been used, the very richly decorated facade has been made. And a very interesting church designed by Guarini is the Cappella della Santa Messa Sindono in Turin. It has hexagonal arcade forms that forms the base of the dome. It has a hexagonal arcade. This has an arcade that forms and diminishing segmental arches. You can see how the dome has been formed. It has segmental arches, and when it moves up, they are reducing. These segmental arches has been reducing, forming a dome with the oculus. You can see it. It is how the construction of dome in this building is very unusual and very inventive. Another architect following the Baroque architecture style was Filippo Guava. He was the follower of people of Carlo Fontana. Fluid forms, weightless details, and the airy prospects of Guava architecture anticipated the art of Rococo. So his design was turned into the Rococo architecture style, and they were more resembling the Rococo architecture style. His practice ranged well beyond Turin. The usual impact of Basilica di Superga, you can see we have talked about, which have a screw type of facade, the dome, derives from its soaring roof lines and masterful placement on a hill above Turin, 15 feet high above the city. This is apse of St. Peter Basilica has been designed by Bernini in Baroque architecture style.